As you know, Hans Andersen's story, The Emperor's New Clothes, refers to a couple of businessmen who go to a city and set up a silk loom, which they tell people is able to make a fantastic, wondrous material, which has the special property that it can only be seen by very, very clever people. So, of course, the court and the the knobs and all the people at the top, they don't see the silk loom, on which there is nothing, absolutely nothing being woven. But of course they can't say that. They have to appear clever. And so the deception goes on. Of course, in recent weeks, we've learned all about corruption and deception at the top. So we can believe this story now, which was a legend prior to this occurrence. And I gave the course this title because, indeed, we are able to spot musical deceptions. And in the course of the week, what we did was we looked at compositional process rather than different styles. And I'm pleased to say, after many years of doing this, people no longer actually refer to style. It has not been an issue this week. It wasn't an issue the last time I taught this course a few years ago. And I'm hoping it's not going to be an issue for you. These pieces are by genuine weavers. There is no nothing going on here, and the material is entirely wholesome, and so on and so forth. And thank goodness here is Stephanie able to rescue me from my dilemma and putting a piece in. I will put this concert into two bits, and I will end the first part with Colin Johnson's Fixie. Bless you. I will put Renata's piece in the second half somewhere nice. So I think you have programs, don't you? So rather than me announce all the pieces, I'm very grateful to Ed Kane rescuing me from the dilemma of two pieces which I was just completely unable to play for technical reasons. And so he's assisting me with those. And of course you'll see which ones they are later. Thank you.
Thank you.
as you all know each other, I think what I'll do is to get the composers down at the end, because that seems a better way to do it, maybe. Hang on, I need the program now. No.
Could announce the pieces at some point that
we
don't know which one you're playing.
Oh dear. Okay. I'm very sorry. There was no time to rehearse this show either. Well, what I have just played was Colin G. Johnson's Fixie. Before that, the very slow, delicate, quiet piece was by Niloufar Habibian, and it's called Lullaby. Before that, there was a kind of soundscape by Lawrence Rose, which is called Red Shanks, which is the name of a bird, familiar from Norfolk to me. Martin Humphrey's quite sad lament, Lone Wolf, preceded that, the very graceful two-part invention, which began and then had a very low section, was by Jill Graham. The wonderful fun fugue, Fuga Barbara, which means barbarous fugue, or indeed it means lots of things in Italian, actually. let's stick with barbarous fugue. That was preceded by Claudia Teschner's Es geht eine dunkle Wolke herein, preceded by Colin Blundell's Piece of Cake, which is in two sections, but they're kind of continuous, but they have nice titles. The first one is called Crumbly, and the second one is called Things Happen, which indeed they do. And the very first piece was a piece by Sheena Phillips, which is graciously called Happy Birthday, Michael Finnessy, which I hope you all agree with in sentiment. So now I'll announce them in pairs, if that's okay. I'm going to play now, and I'm inserting Renata's piece after this. So, first of all, you'll hear Growing Pains by Edward Kane, and then Mr. Brahms Goes to Coventry by Renata Vendon. Maybe it would be efficient to get the rest of the material now while I can still see something.
Thank you.
next two pieces are Chroma Collage 2016, Chopsticks and Car the Yowls by Pat Hanchett, and Brahms with 20% Extra Accidentals by Leo Grant. The next pair of pieces are an untitled piece, which I don't think Charlotte would mind my describing as a sort of whistle-stop tour of the Promenade concerts with a kind of linking theme. and Hollowness by Cheryl Z. Loke. Thank you. pieces are Pier and Ocean, the title of a wonderful painting by Mondrian, by Carrie Andrews, and the tightrope minuet by Rob Farnos. Anna Claydon's piece is absolutely amazing, but those of you of a slightly nervous disposition should be warned that it does contain expletives. Which are part of the piece. They're not my reaction to what I'm doing. Is Dear Harpy. I love doing it every minute of it, but it's really hard to shout. Those of you that want to do this in the future, it's really hard to shout a text in a cramped up pelvic position on a piano stool and play consistent semi-quavers with clusters at the outside of the strings of the keyboard. Beyond even my capabilities.
It's quite hard to sit next to him while he's doing it.
Okay, the last two pieces are a valse by Paul Buckley, and I love this title. He didn't disco fly so good. I'm not going to attempt the American accent. It's by Brandon Chang. And I'm also doing this as a duet with Ed. So first the vowels, hold on. I would also like to apologise to all the composers concerned that these have been sketches for performances rather than actual performances, and if any of you check with the recording and the straw, you will detect undoubtedly a great many mistakes. Thanks a lot.